Hi everyone, I'm Sherry Bechtel, editor for Finder's Investing Channel, and I'm here with the best trading apps for beginners. We compared many, but chose the top three that had an easy, intuitive app, commission-free stocks and ETFs, and an overall positive user experience. We'll take a look at their pros and cons and help you choose the right one for your needs. Let's dive in. Robinhood was one of the first trading platforms to bring commission-free trading and a simple mobile app to its users. This makes it an excellent choice for investors who are just starting out and have no prior trading experience. To open a trading account, you don't need thousands of dollars. You can do so with any amount, even 10 bucks. What's more, you don't have to buy a full share if you can't afford it. With the fractional shares feature, you can buy fractions of shares of any company you want. For example, if an Apple share costs $120, you can buy half a share for $60. Recently, Robinhood added a new feature that lets you buy initial public offering stocks at IPO prices, a feature that few trading platforms offer today. On top of all of this, you can also invest in stocks, ETFs, options, and cryptocurrencies. Despite having all of these cool features to help you start your investing journey, Robinhood does have its downsides. Being a beginner-friendly platform, Robinhood lacks advanced charting and research features. And as a beginner, this may not impact you as much. But after you learn and grow as an investor, you may want to consider switching to another app. Robinhood is also a poor choice if you're looking for an automated investment feature. The app doesn't let computer algorithms invest on your behalf. Sofi offers all the standard features you'll find in similar apps, but it also offers a platform where you can consolidate and manage all of your finances, something rare in this industry. You can manage your Sofi cash account, personal and student loans, Sofi credit card, or you can invest, all within the one Sofi app. Of course, if you only want to use the app to buy stocks, ETFs, or crypto, that's a great option too. There's no minimum deposit to open an investing account, meaning you can deposit $5 and start buying stocks. Similar to Robinhood, Sofi lets you buy fractional shares, a feature Sofi calls stock bits. This lets you buy a piece of any US share you want, starting from $5. You can also show interest to buy IPO stocks at IPO prices, but Sofi doesn't guarantee that they'll fill your order. Where Sofi shines is its automated investing feature, which lets a computer algorithm automatically trade on your behalf based on parameters that you set. What's more, the automated investment has no management fee, a great benefit for set it and forget it investors. Despite these features, Sofi won't be the perfect investment platform for everyone. For example, crypto investors and traders may be disappointed with its flat 1.25% fee for crypto trading. This falls way short of Robinhood, where crypto trading comes with zero fees. And if you want advanced trading charts, you'll likely find the Sofi app subpar. There's only a line chart to track stock prices, which is often not enough for advanced traders. Finally, we have Webull, one of the best trading apps not just for beginners, but advanced traders as well. Here's why. The Webull app offers the most extensive research you can get compared to Sofi or Robinhood. You can see analyst ratings and analyst price targets to help you understand what to expect from every stock you track. Plus, you get some of the most sophisticated charts you can get with a mobile app. There's also a paper trading option, which means beginners can practice and learn by trading virtual money before investing the real thing. You won't find this feature with Sofi or Robinhood. Even more, there's no commission for trading stocks in ETFs. Now that you know Webull's strong points, let's see where it fails. You can't buy fractions of shares like you can with Sofi and Robinhood. And while the Webull app is more sophisticated than the other two, it comes with a learning curve for beginners. To wrap up, all three of these apps are excellent starting points for beginners. If you're still torn on which is the right one for you, you can read the full review of each by checking out our guides. They're linked in the description box below. And if you liked this video, subscribe and hit that notification bell so you'll be the first to know when a new Finder video drops. Thanks for watching.